Well, the reason we made Midnight McCartney really came from Paul McCartney himself. I received a letter from him, and he just had an idea. He said, you know, you could do some of these post-Beatles songs, like Junk and Warm and Beautiful. And then maybe there, he said there'd be a dishy little picture of you against the Manhattan skyline, and we could call it Midnight McCartney. And we said, well, I think that's a great idea.
Sister Susie, Brother John, Martin Luther, Phil and Don, Uncle Ernie, Auntie Jim, open the door, let them in, yeah. Oh.
It's more of a musical relationship that I have with Paul McCartney. I did play rhythm guitar on his Kisses on the Bottom CD. We did a Music Cares event. We did the Grammys, and we did a live iTunes concert. So we spent a lot of time together talking about music and say, John, you play here, you know. I was excited that Paul wrote me the letter. It's very flattering to think that I thought that my interpretations of these things would be important.
You think that people would have had enough of silly love songs?
The thing that's interesting about reinterpretation is there's rediscovery in reinterpretation. Silly love songs, I felt like it could be like a bossa nova because the message is so simple. And as a bossa nova, simplicity is what sells it, I think. It almost has a different meaning in a sense. It was already a great song, but it has a little sweeter meaning, I think, to it. It'll be like... I look high, I look low. When we set out to record the record, I think it was really, as always, trying to come up with 12, 13, 14 songs that when you turn them into something else, you go, oh, that was a great idea, as opposed to, oh, that was such an idea.
That's a pretty damn good little song. Yeah, you don't have to make a thing out of it. Just like my prom date.
And having reinterpreted Richard Rodgers and Duke Ellington and Sinatra, you know, you start to get a feeling for what's right and what's wrong. And on this record, I really felt like all the trial and error from the past helped what happened here.
Maybe I'm a man, maybe you're the only woman who could ever help me. Baby, won't you help me to understand? Baby, I'm a me.
Well, yeah, I'm very excited to bring this material on the road. I actually got a chance to do a little bit of it at the Montreal Jazz Festival. You mentioned Paul McCartney, everybody gets excited. It was amazing to see how everybody was in.
I'm amazed with you.
The energy on stage has been very exciting. You know, it's been very high and there's a joy to it. Making this record has been an amazing process for me, and I think we did a really good job with it, and I was very happy to be asked.